Thank you, sir.
Sri Nimala Krishnappa.
Honorable Speaker, thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to speak on the problems being faced by the silk cocoon farmers and silk weavers in Andhra Pradesh. I would like to state that Andhra Pradesh state occupies the second highest position in silk cocoon farming in the country and also occupies first position in handloom weaving in the country. The weakening position of the handloom sector has posed a serious threat to the socio-economic status of silk weavers and silk cocoon farmers. Silk cocoon farming and silk weaving both are interrelated activities. Both are under the control of Ministry of Textiles and are the major crisis due to various reasons. One side, silk weavers are committing suicide due to debts. On the other side, silk cocoon farmers also attempting suicide for not getting minimum support price. To save the lives of silk weavers, silk yarn may be provided on subsidy rate on 50% per kg, then only silk weavers will survive. Silk cocoon farmers are not getting minimum support price for the cocoons. Silk farmers also may be provided 150 rupees per kg subsidy on cocoons, then only silk farmers will survive. Another important issue is the National Horticulture Board is providing 2 lakh subsidy for horticulture farmers for the unit cost of 4 lakhs in the name of pack house, whereas Central Silk Board is providing only 1 lakh subsidy on 5 lakhs of unit cost in the name of silk rearing shed. I would also like to ask government why there is discrimination between agriculture farmers and silviculture farmers when both are doing farming activities. In this regard, I would like to request to government to increase the subsidy up to 2.5 lakhs for silk rearing sheds also. Hence, I urge upon the Honorable Minister of Textile through the chair of to kindly look into the issue and take necessary steps to overcome the problems of silk weavers and silk cocoon farmers to improve their social and economic status. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.